So, welcome everybody. Thank you to be here this morning. It's really an honor for me to be in front of you. Today we will talk about the worst application I ever saw in my life, Amada. So, who am I? My name is Baptiste Robert en français. I am a French security researcher, and for the last 2 years I'm publishing my research on Twitter under the pseudonym of Elliot Alberto. My research is mainly focused on mobile applications, especially Android apps. Today I will tell you a story. So beginning of 2008, I was on the beach in Barcelona. Due to my previous discoveries on OnePlus, on Wiko, as the presenter said, my Twitter account was already quite big. So I was on the beach and I started to receive a lot of private messages asking me to look at an application called Amada. It's quite usual for me to receive this kind of request, but this time I received a lot of messages on the same apps. So I was on vacation, I had time, so I decided to look at it. So first, we have to understand what is ADA. ADA has been introduced by the Indian government in 2012. It's a 12-digit number, a unique identity number that can be obtained by residents of India based on their biometric and demographic information. With 1.2 billion of people, ADA is the biggest identification program of the world. And it's a very, very, very hot topic in India. In their everyday life, Indians need to show their ADA card for many formalities. To make life easier for them, the Indian government created Amada, an Android application, in order to carry this demographic information. So the first thing I'm doing when I'm starting this kind of analysis is looking at the Play Store description. There is a description: Amada is the official mobile application developed by the Unique Identification Authority of India, UDI. It allows the user to download their ADA profile with their demographic details on their phone. So this is very interesting from an attacker point of view. This application is responsible of storing biometric data. It makes this app a super good target for someone like me. So the first thing I'm doing when I'm doing this kind of assessment, I download the application, I install it on my device, and try to run it. And I have this screen, this pop-up. So in this pop-up, as you can see, I have the message: your device is rooted for security purposes. You can't use this application. Okay, so there is a root detection inside the application. They don't want the users to use their application on rooted devices, which makes sense because we are talking about biometric data, so why not? Because I like to understand things, I try to bypass this mechanism. So let's see this together. So I decompiled the application and I started analysis in order to find where the root detection has been implemented in the application. In practice, this is super easy to do. You just have to decompile the application, and here either I just search the message I had in the pop-up, your device is rooted, blah blah blah. So I found this screen in the splash screen activity, which is the first screen you are seeing in the application. And you can see that there is only one method call in order to check if your device is rooted. So if you look at what the A object is, in the first line, you can see that we called a method A. This method is called in the package called com.scott.root.beer. And this is interesting because this is not a UDL package. They didn't implement a root their own root detection. They use an open source library. So this library is available on GitHub, so you have all the details. So okay, so we understand how they did that. We have two choices to bypass this. The first is to tamper the application. You can decompile the application, you will have some smolly code, modify the smolly code, recompile the app, and resign the application. The main disadvantage of this is you have to resign the app, and sometimes it's not cool for various reasons. The best solution here is to use Frida. Frida is a dynamic instrumentation toolkit which allows you to inject your own script into Blackwork processes. So this is what I did here. So in order to bypass the root detection, this is super easy. You just have to write four lines of JavaScript, and you ask to Frida, okay, every time the A method of the B class is called return false. Like this, the application will think, okay, the device is not rooted. Okay, so we bypass the root detection, great. Now, something that I like to do when I analyze Android application is to tamper the application. It can be really useful. So I decompile the application, modify it, recompile it, resign it, install on my device, and launch it. And I received this pop-up without any error message, an empty screen. So I did the same thing. I looked at the decompiled source code and I found these two methods, check signature and check package name. Again, you can see that this is super easy to bypass because these two trivial check can be bypassed with Frida. You just have to ask to Frida, okay, every time these two methods are called, return false. And we can use the application like this. So another thing I like to do, and this is really, really useful, is to tamper the application in order to set the debug flag to true in the Android manifest. Like this, when you will recompile the application with the debug flag activated, you will be able to attach the debugger to the application, set some breakpoint, and you will have more information in the log, which is cool. So this is what I did. The application crashed. So okay, they did something else. They implemented something in the application. So I looked at the source code and I found a class where the application is trying to load something and is doing an operation, a string manipulation. And the application is crashing because when the app is trying to replace the string in the third line, the string is not okay. As an attacker, what you have to understand when you analyze this kind of thing, you just want to bypass this. You don't have to understand really what this thing is doing. So with Frida, you just have to say, okay, when this method is called, I don't care of the detail, just return okay, and we are fine. So the latest version of MADAR is 1.1.7, and in the version 1.1.4, they started to implement a version check in order to force people to update their application to the latest version. They implemented this mechanism. Okay, this is another challenge because sometimes I really like to analyze the previous version because you can find some cool bug in the old version. So when you open an old version of the application, you will receive this pop-up. And if you don't click on update now, you cannot do anything. So we have to find a way to bypass this pop-up. Again, I did the same thing. I just search the string of the pop-up in the column. I found this, and again, else did the same thing. I just ask every time, so as you can see in this slide, every time this pop-up is triggered, only if the C method in the first line return false. So you just have to ask to figure out, okay, in order to bypass this mechanism, I just need to return true every time the C method is called. So as you can see, Frida is really useful for a lot of stuff when you analyze application, because if you want to find vulnerabilities, you don't care about all this security mechanism, and here, this is very easy to bypass. They implement security mechanism. I can imagine someone in India ask to the UDI developer, hey guys, you have to implement some stuff, and they took the checklist and say, okay, we have good detection, we have tampering detection, but they implemented everything on the Java side. And on the Java side, you can bypass everything. So another thing is, when you install the application is asking you to set a user a password. So the user should set a password in order to protect his information. So I took the different version of the application. I took the very first version in 2015. The second screen is 2018, and the last screen is a current version. As you can see, the requirements on the password, we have less requirements on the password. So first, the requirement was between 6, your password should contain between 6 and 12 characters. After that, it was 8 characters, and at the end, today, they just say, ah, oh, fuck off, 4 digits is okay. You can use 1, 2, 3, 4. So, and another point is, the show password checkbox is enabled by default. So this is clearly, don't do that. So this is the funniest part of this analysis. So this, as I said at the beginning, this application is storing biometric data of people. This app has been downloaded 10 million of times. So this is a big application. They store all the information in an encrypted database, which is fine, which is very cool. They use a famous library to do that called SQLite Cypher. But in order to open your encrypted database, you need to generate a password. Okay, so I am an hacker, I like to understand things. So how did they generate the password for the application? So in 2018, the current version was 1.1.0. Are you able to see the problem? Yeah, the C is hard-coded, so every time this method is called, the password is the same. So in 2018, the database was encrypted, yes, but the password was the same for 10 million of people. Okay, good job. So in the current version of the application, Because I disclosed this, I will talk of the disclosure process after, but because I disclosed this, they said, okay, we have to do something on the latest version. We have to generate the password differently. And they just took the IMEI of the device, of the user device. So now the password is different for every user. But this is not okay. According to the best practices by Team Zetetic, which is a company behind SQLite Cypher, don't do this. If you want to generate a password for your encrypted database, you have to take a significant part of the key material is a secret coming directly from the user when the application is running. It's they state in their website that according the key in the application code is not okay. Don't do this. So another thing I like to do when I analyze application is to find some debug features. It's very common for developers, mobile developers, to implement some debug feature on the application, and sometimes they forget to remove the debug feature in the production build. So this is what I did for this application, and I found a method called write log. So there was a log mechanism inside the application, and as you can see in this screenshot, in order to activate this write log method, you just have to set a variable isLogger to true. That's all. So again, I use Prila and say, okay, every time my write log method is called, just set the isLogger value to true. Like this, it will write a log file inside the SD card. And what do I have in my log file? I have all the network requests made by the application. You don't have to sniff the network traffic. The application is doing it for you. Which is okay, cool. And when I prepare this talk, I started to work on this application in 2018, so it's pretty old for me. I did a lot of stuff after that, and I was like, okay, it can be cool to show to people something of the latest application. So I download the latest application, use my data script in order to bypass everything, and I use the application, sniff the traffic, and I found these two requests. When you click on FAQ and when you click on help, the application is doing two HTTP requests. I have a long history with UDI, with this application, and still, after 2 years, they continue to have something like this on their application. We are in 2019, guys. HTTP call is not okay. So, I want also to talk about the responsible disclosure, because this is something super important. This is a node debate I have on Twitter, and we all have in this community. Disclose a vulnerability is complicated. Disclose a vulnerability in India is even complicated. And disclose a vulnerability related to something governmental is even harder. Trust me. In India, it can be super complicated to disclose something. Some security researchers has been arrested, or some has been threatened by the police. And this is not okay. It has to stop. Security researchers are here to help. And I think it's not a crime, so we are here to help and to disclose some cool stuff. In 2018, ADA was one of the hottest subjects in India. These vulnerabilities has been on all the Indian media, and it was just crazy. Under this exposition, this public exposition is very complicated. So if you are in this situation, take care. Despite all my effort, UDI never contacted me. I disclosed, I think, maybe 10 vulnerabilities in their product, and they never sent me any message. I asked them to contact me a lot of time, and they just don't want to discuss. So this is crazy. If UDI is here, or if UDI can hear me, you have to set up a disclosure process. This is super, super important. So just to finish, the first application, the title of my talk was the worst application, because the first version of the application was crazy. I mean, when I was an intern, my code was better than this. And here, we are talking about something for 10 million of people and potentially 1.2 billion of people affected. So for something governmental, it's crazy to have a code quality like this. They started to consider the security after I disclosed the issues. But as you can see, still in the latest application, it's vulnerable to man-in-the-middle attacks. And if you want to set some check in the later in the Java side, you can see that this is not okay. You can do some stuff on the Java side, but you need to implement some security mechanism in the native layer too. Because if everything is on the Java side, you can bypass it very easily. And the disclosure process to finish, the disclosure process was and is still a mess. We need a disclosure process for ADA, for UDI, for governmental programs in India, but in other countries too. And we are here again, we are here to help. We are open to discussion and stop threatening people. We are here to stay, and we will continue what we are doing. Thank you. If you want to discuss, I will be around after the talk.